So, how's your esteem like? How's your esteem like? Do you feel good? Do you feel bad? Bad sense of yourself, good sense of yourself, better sense of yourself, or worse sense of yourself? How do you find yourself? You find yourself, or you see yourself in a very good shape? It's all about your esteem. Even in business, if you cannot, you know, project your esteem to a certain level, you may not be able to succeed. Because life is not there for those who want to make it, but life is there for those who have resolved to make it in Christ Jesus. Once you resolve in the Lord that it is possible, it is well, then of course it's going to be well with you. So it is important to see the type of esteem we have. Today we'll go through the Bible, a few verses, and I know Jehovah will help us go through some, if not all of them. Shall we pray? That the Lord, we have come again as your children. We know not of even ourselves, except when your spirit clearly defined and make it clear unto us who we are and what we are. May you come and edify us through your word. May your spirit always bring upon us the breath of wisdom and knowledge so that we'll be able to go and live out the entirety of the gospel to the world around us. Help us, Holy Spirit, as I stand, may it not be me, self, that stands, but may it be you who will speak through me. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. So as we started this two series already, this about the third one about our esteem. There are some guiding principles that we need that will guide us. For example, one of the principles that we need to know could be found in Romans 12, 3. We read it the other time. Romans 12, 3. Romans chapter 12. Yes. 3. For by the grace given me, I say to every one of you, do not think of yourself more highly than you ought, but rather think of yourself with sober judgment, in accordance with the measure of faith God has given you. So the first principle I thought we should keep in our minds and our spirit is that do not think more highly of yourself than you ought. If it is a self-esteem, the godly way we are talking about, if it is a self-esteem, the godly way we are talking about, then do not think of yourself more highly than you ought. Than you ought. Yes, you don't see yourself more highly than you are. Sometimes you think you are much more of a certain value. Maybe your training and your vocation and your skills will warrant you up to a certain value. But you may be thinking of yourself of a highest value. But my brother or my sister, you are not there yet. You will be there one day. So objectivity is important here. To be more objective to yourself and truthful to yourself. To be more honest in assessing yourself is what we are talking about. So don't see yourself more highly than you ought to. But why do you want to bless yourself? Sometimes we speak of superiority complex as a virtue, something that we need to embrace. But blessing is superiority complex within the context of scripture, it doesn't work. For scripture, it is not about superiority complex. It is about thinking about yourself in a balanced manner. Don't see yourself too much of what you are. Sometimes some people even think that when I should leave this committee and I will not work in this committee again, the church will collapse. It will never collapse. Even if I live here today, this church shall never collapse. Don't see yourself too big. Sometimes some of us are too big in in our relationships. And that doesn't please the Lord. We should be doing things that will please the Lord. What the Lord has said is what should be our measure. Our yardstick is what Scripture says. So, principle number one, don't think yourself more highly than we actually are. The second principle Paul talked about here, don't think yourself less than you actually are. Don't think yourself less than you actually are. Because, you know, when you think about yourself more highly than you are, it's pride. You know that? It's pride. The Lord knows who are proud and arrogant that begin to think about themselves more highly than they are. Some of us, we come from a certain royal roots. And that royalty has been the thing that has led us into arrogance and pride. We see ourselves, I'm from this home, I'm from this family, I'm from this clan, and so on. All of us, we hear from certain village where we are this year over there. Come to my village, I'm a big boss there. Okay, I come from a village. Before my ancestors moved from that village to Kedek and settled there some 94th century era. Where I come from, my roots really is close to, you know, where they sell the sugar cane along Accra Road. You see, that's where I live from. That's where I really live from. But my ancestors left there because of marriage and settled in Kelly, and then forever we'll be there. But we'll be going to a school. The last time I was there was when I was with my MPO and I embarked on the research on the environment and things like that. So I did a research on Akikobulawa traditional area. So I have to go around checking all that places to conduct my research and survey and things like that. Then I went to my hometown. I saw the Shabeni who has been visiting us once in a while in Kenya. And I went and asked for the woman who visited them. He said, this is for this year for Mother Kasamia. And straight away, he took me to the chief of the town. And he asked the chief, do you know this young man? The chief said, no. He said, he's supposed to be sitting on this chair. So not proud, we should not be proud of ourselves with everything outside the confines of God. Because everything outside the work of God is just temporary. They will perish one time and you will never find them again. So anytime you see yourself more highly than you are proud and you are arrogant. I should not be proud. And you should not. All of us must subject ourselves to the directions of God and to the dictates of Scripture. And when you see yourself less than you ought to, that is also too bad. When you are seeing yourself less than you ought to, it is also too bad. That is false humility. You are pretending to be humble, but you are not. There are people like that. They pretend that we are not what we are supposed to be. You are what you are. What you are and what the Lord has placed in you is defines what you are. You do not define what you are until the Lord places something in you and makes it known to you, and that defines you. So what the Lord has placed on us and in us defines who you are. So who you are is who you are. We should not pretend to be less than who we are. That is false humility. In fact, in essence, that is also pride. To be pretending to be something very, very less than what you are. Why do you want to do principles to guide us, esteem ourselves in a more balanced manner. If we don't have that, then we may not be able to balance ourselves. So in between the two, the high and the low, comes the middle, which is supposed to be the honest assessment of who you are. So you are neither there nor here, but you are the middle. And that gives you a balanced assessment of who you are. I'm not suggesting that when people tell you you are poor, say, okay, that is my biological state, I am poor. There are certain confessions when you are settled, they come to pass and they establish in your life. Are you getting it? Yes. So I'm not suggesting that. You cannot be poor. But also, if you don't have the resources, don't move around priding yourself to everybody that look ahead. I get you. You know, some people, even when they don't have, they will go and they will buy things and other things in credit. And they walk around showing off. Showing off. Sometimes you see them dancing with their, not even flying time, water. And then it comes with its strings and you see them with gorgeous shoes. Well, that is like really very important. Only to realize that all of those things are done on credit. You could not live your life. That is also part of pride and arrogance. Look at your resources and live according to your resources. That is the balance assessment of what you are. You really don't die, don't have much money in your pocket now. But we are only praying and hoping that one day you will be fabulously rich. But for today, what you have is what you spend. If you have to go out with the long lady, please, before you go out, make it clear to the lady that you are not a man of greater resources. You are an average resource, financial resource person. So don't heighten the lady's expectation. That can take me to KFS, take the whole box of chicken and all that. Once you know that you don't really, really have the resources, should you spend that money the next week or two, you are enjoying. And yet, some young men will not do that. They don't want to be original. They want to be counterfeit. And so your self-esteem is the original shape that the world has placed on you. Anything more than that is counterfeit. Young men, when you are approaching young ladies for your sons, you love them for marriage, please pray. Prayer will do the trick, not KFC. Are you getting it? Take that lady to more. It's not a trick. The trick is praying. Praying and seeing the God's mandate given to you in that. Once you have the green light of the Lord, please go ahead. Chest forward. Big smile. And tell the lady, I love you. Maybe by the grace of God, I love you. You people, we don't know how to do that. Really, at our time, there were no mobile phones when they were not around. At our time, there were no mobile phones. Now, in our days, we didn't have vehicles. We pray and go forward with the strength of Jehovah. And it works. Before I met my wife and I said, see, Lord, you know, that thing is difficult for me to do. To stand and say, but if I go, don't let me down. I'll do a whole prayer. The whole prayer. And I don't wish that the lady tells me, go and two men are giving them a book. How would that feel with these two men? Maybe she'll be going to tell her friend, and her friend will be telling her, how right, I say, and God is telling me, oh my God, this is the thing about God. I want instant answer. And all of you, when I fasted a And it was a mess. I knew the Lord was working. God was on my side. By the time we finished our conversation, I asked a second question. So, we might be closer to the week. He said, I'm from China.
Differences to it. That should not build into us
a scheme of self-sufficiency. But that should rather remind us that somebody has given this. You know, one of the things that the Lord has blessed me, and I thank Him so much. You know, any time I woke up in the morning and I look at where the mattress on which I sleep, I say, Father, I thank You. I bless You. I bless You. I just bless them all. I just bless them all. Resources or no resources, I bless them all. Because my daddy and my mommy, they gave birth to 11 children. 11. 8 boys, 3 girls. And for the last 6 or so, were only boys. You can imagine, your daddy is a civil servant. My daddy was a lay preacher in the Presbyterian church, so he wouldn't take pride. I just wanted to educate all the 11 children in secondary school. Because the children were men, my mommy was a household keeper. So, those of us, when I knew how my big sisters and brothers have grown and they have left, they were working. But I remember those of us who were there. We sleep on a deck, and then the other might sleep on a mattress. That type of mattress was the strong one. That's one question. Okay. So from Kete, are you getting it? From Kete, Matt. I'm not saying Kete is evil. I'm not saying, but we progress, isn't it? We progress. So from Kete to student mattress in secondary school. And then coming over to single bed as a single young guy. And then getting married to double bed as a young couple. And then transferring to queen mattress as you get to the middle age. And then king mattress as you go. Is it not progressive? Is the Lord not blessing you? Yes, that is progressive. That is how you want to see life. Begin to think that you have to lift yourself up, and all of a sudden, and this guy is just preparing to marry, and all of a sudden, he's thinking about king size mattress, queen size mattress, and why the resources are not there. So you will not be able to appreciate God for the things the Lord has done. But if you can progress one step at a time, looking back from where you got started, all God started, then you will really be able to appreciate God for where the Lord has put you. When I came to this church, the church rented the place for me in Moscow. From there, I moved to my own house. It's positive progression. Are you getting it? It's positive progression. I look at it and I say, oh, I'm a Moscow. Anyway. People of God, look at where your balance is. Don't see yourself too big. Maybe at your level, you still have to live in the wretchedness. That is okay for now. As you pray and ask the Lord to bless you even more. Are you people getting it? Yes. Maybe at this moment, you should be eating a certain kind of food. Not food that will kill you though. You should be eating a certain kind of food. That is all right. Pray the Lord will lift you up and you move to the next level. Perhaps at this moment you have to work under a certain boss or chain of commands. It is all right to have a supervisor and to have a senior supervisor and to have the boss of himself. It is all right for God. But don't just begin to think that, oh, why should we have more than me? When I was writing my own level in the A-level, when I was in the dorm for my first degree, or when I was in campus for my first degree, where is he? He just came from JHSSS and he wants to be my boss. My brother, you are mistaken. Again, the work I am, the work I am, the work I am. Are you getting it? Can we sign it together? Again, the work I am. Yeah, they need one more mind. will set you on this thing. Can you do that? Look out. And that's how life is all about. If you have chain of bosses, chain of command, please accept that. And pray and work hard. The Lord will get you there. Don't see yourself too high. That ought to watch you. Humble yourself. And don't see yourself too low. Because that is not where you are. Be in the balance. Let the Holy Spirit help you define yourself. Let the Holy Spirit help you define yourself. Pray that the Lord will honor us this week to guide our self-esteem so that we will not be abstract in our thinking of our own self-esteem. That objectivity will flash and flash us into the proper self-esteem. Before I sing, I want to read this text to us. When I look at Psalm chapter 8, Psalm number 8, 3 to 8. Psalm number 8, 3 to 8. When I look at the night sky and see the work of your fingers, what are mortals that you should think of us? So in the friend, the Lord put us in charge of everything He made. God made us His image or likeness. The first sign is the value the Lord places on us. No other creature received the image of God. Only us have received the image of God. But the second sign we also see is that the Lord placed everything under us. So one, we bear the stewards, custodians of everything the Lord has made. So don't see yourself too low. Don't see yourself too high. But see yourself at exactly what the Lord has placed you. May the Lord bless us. Turn to somebody and say, my sister, my brother, don't see yourself too high than you ought to be. You don't see yourself too low than you are. Place yourself within the context of Scripture, and the Lord will bless you.